in relation to this.
Now you can say it.
You don't have to wear your wind cheater anymore. You can wear a ram one, all right? Oh, beautiful.
Upgraded ugly vest.
Guess what?
Nearly there. Welcome back to another episode with DNA. So today is Friday, and what does that mean, Dave?
Hopefully, pickup day of the new car. We went down on Monday to see what was going on, as you might have seen on the shorts that we put up. We also spoke to him, and he wasn't, obviously, they pay a floor plan on this car, or any car that they get once they've been invoiced. So he's paying money. We're paying money.
Everyone's paying money.
So it's in their best interest to get it out as fast as they can. Yeah. So we go and come home Monday afternoon, Tuesday morning, 8:30, get a text message saying it's here. So straight away, they put it in the workshop. They got all the stuff, the tow bar put on, the Anderson plug, another Anderson plug into the tub for us. And yesterday, frantically trying to get somewhere where they can get it over the pits, they found somewhere. The earliest they could get in was this morning, which is Friday. But they had to go to Forestfield. So Forestfield to from Rockingham to Forestfield's not just around the corner. It's a good hour drive. So he's not guaranteeing it today, but he said as long as they get it back early enough, which means they've got to take the plates off the patrol, put them onto that, get it registered, fingers crossed. Anyway, Nick's going down to get a haircut.
Yep.
And
bit of a tidy up.
Bit of a tidy up before we take off. So with a bit of luck, we'll get this
Ram today.
Woo!
Woohoo, finally.
Well, we're excited, but we're sort of cautious as well because
We may not.
So we'll say, Jesus, this seat's hot. What are you doing?
Sorry, I put the...
Oh, burning me bum.
Put the heat...
Just because you're cold doesn't mean I'm cold.
Oh, well.
All right, we're going to get going because we're not going to make it if I don't start moving.
All right. Let yous know what happens, guys. Cheers. Okay. Without waiting, and we went down yesterday to see if the car was there or arriving or anything. We went shopping and they bought this.
Well, just we need a fire pit, but I don't like the ones you got to put together as a pain in the ass. So this is just a gas bottle that's had this bit cut off the top, put on the bottom. It's got all holes in that, but it does fit into this, so you can also carry it. What I'm going to do is mount it up here, so I'll bolt that through, but I've actually bought a bracket so that I can bolt that bracket to there, then that can go to there, and that'll give us 3 points of contact, and then the barbecue thing sits in there.
So it's not barbecue.
Well, it will be if I put a barbecue plate on. So I'll get it. I'm not going to bore you with drilling holes and what's done, but I'll show you once it's finished. But yeah, that's what we're going to do. That way we can carry the fire pit.
Oh, sorry. I just had to have my 5 cents first. And...
5 cents? $5.
Maybe 10. And then we can have a little fire tonight. I forgot the marshmallows, but that's okay. Yeah. I had 2 donuts today.
Yeah, 2 donuts instead. All right, we'll come back to you once I've done this.
How's it going, love?
Yeah, it's all right. No, don't buy the Ryobi drill bits.
No good?
Well, you get one hole out of them and then they're useless.
Yeah.
Righto, holes are drilled. Just going to put a bit of silicone in behind this bracket just to help with vibrations, and then on each bolt we'll have a bit of silicone. Just holes there, holes in there. So I'll get this in and then we'll do it. Okay, so I've just put a bit of silicone behind that and on the nut just to help with vibrations. Now I've drilled, when you do get these they have the holes here, but I didn't want it hanging down here, So I put a bracket on there, drilled three holes so that it actually sits on top and it's not vibrating. And then I'll just bolt it down like that, hopefully. We'll see how it goes. Tighten these up, get all the silicon to ooze out, and then I'll wipe it up once it's, at least with the silicon it helps create a seal so that it doesn't vibrate. Moment of truth. Let's see if it'll. There we go. Not going anywhere. Can always put a bit of kindling and stuff in there.
And where do we get it from?
This one we got off Facebook. Was $50. The bracket was $39 from BCF. The other little bracket and the nuts and bolts cost me another $12. So
cheap as chips.
Yeah, and then we got the firewood on the front. Next thing is trying to work out how I'm going to stop someone knocking it off. Might have to put a
padlock.
Like a padlock or something. I don't know. Might be able to go through there with a chain or something. But hopefully, no one. They do. They're going to take it anyway, aren't they?
Good job.
Beautiful.
We'll check out the fire later on.
Yep, we'll try it up later.
Oh, getting it all set up ready for tonight. A little bit of a fire. Emptying out our hoard of wood we've been carting around for a little bit. Oh, it looks lovely.
I'll leave it until it gets dark and then we'll fire her up and see what happens.
Alright, and now it's time to get the suicide on.
No, it's time for a beer. You've had your donuts, I'm going to have my beer.
Whatever. Alright, beer o'clock.
The old trusty ARB fridge. I've had this for, probably 12 years. It's on its second latch. Needs another one. But still works a treat. I suppose I better feed the pig too, eh?
Yeah.
Give her a drumstick.
Yep.
You ready? Chicky time. Righto, beer o'clock.
Cheers.
Cheers, we don't have to wait long, it's 4 o'clock. Another 40 minutes, I can kick this in the guts, fire it up. I've got the blower there to get it roaring. Dog's eating the chicken. Oh, you've already had your donuts. So what are we going to do? You want me to do corn suicide? Oh, yeah, and she's poking her tongue out behind the back there.
Yes, right. Please.
I'll have a swig of this and I'll start the corn suicide for her. Right. You right there, Piggy? Saved me putting on my sleeveless shirt, that jumper that Nick makes.
Oh, I love it so much.
Oh, you love it? Go get it.
So much. Not?
I'm going to light this now while it's got enough light around it to see what's going on. Let me get this to work. Oh, look at that, first go.
Also made sure I shut all the windows on the van in case it got too smoky.
Look at that, just a perfect holder.
The blower.
Get the roaring.
Get a cranking.
My Uggies on.
And she's singing.
Yeah, but I just forgot the marshmallows. What an idiot.
Oh, I've still got the beer, wherever that is.
Over there.
Beautiful. All right, we'll get this going. Won't sit too close because...
Oh, then my hair will smell.
Oh, it'll smell anyway. Just because it's been freshly painted, so we'll let that burn off before we sit around it.
Such a pyro. Have a look at him. He's still at it.
Yeah.
Obsessed, mate. Here, here's your ugly jumper.
Can't be that ugly. You got it for me. Look at that. They're coming back in style, like archers are coming back in style in houses. Body's warm, the rest is warm.
Have a freaking go at it. All right, moment of truth. We're arriving here at Ram.
We're at Ram in Rockham. We haven't, hang on, don't bugger off. We haven't had a phone call or anything yet, but we've just pulled in here on the off chance because it is 3 o'clock in the afternoon and Nick O'Shea writes right out the front there.
Oh my God, I think it's here. I think this one's ours.
Although it's pretty dirty.
Yeah.
Yeah, that one looks like it's just come straight off the boat. Maybe not. Well, let's get out and have a look.
Let's hope that they've done it and got it bloody over the pits. And anyway, let's go check it out. Looks big. Looks big, hey, babe?
It does.
Compared to... our good old patrol.
Actually, easy way to tell. No.
Oh, no.
Well, I haven't even got a tow bar on it yet, so this must be another one.
Oh.
Let's go in and have a look. Quick.
Okay, let's go. Go.
Righto, let's go inside. Let's have a little gander.
Is that the ringing saying it's here? Is that it?
No, that's got a just show. This is
sure.
It's gonna be a fifth wheeler. This must be it.
Oh my God.
Look at the size of it.
Let's see the smile on your dog, is it?
Yeah, that's it. Look at the, because we've got that canopy wire come from the canopy.
Are you sure it's it?
Yeah.
We're not stepping in someone else's car.
Oh, it even smells new. You're going to be able to drive. You're going to be able to drive this thing or what?
Well, we spring. Thank God for that.
Wow.
yeah, it smells so new. Thank God. It's today, it's today.
Here's the boss.
Oh, here's James. Hi, James.
Hi. License.
Yay. All right.
Bad news. Because I licensed the license, and I can't put your blades on. As you can see on here, you can go through the different screens.
Yep.
You've got engine hours and all the rest of it and all the settings. Drivetrain, pitch and roll, driver assist, so this is your lane sense up here.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't want to turn all that shit
it's
off.
It's already off, it stays off all the time as well.
Yep.
Fuel usage and all the rest of it, trip A, trip B, trailer tow, so if you've got your gain down here where you can adjust it, and adjust on the screen up there.
What do you mean gain?
For your trailer brakes.
How much, instead of dialing it,
a push button, you've got your handbrake there, your emergency brake there as well.
Yep.
Keep going through, you've got your audio, what you're listening to, messages, you can set up the screen so you can go through and you can change all the top corners and all the rest of it.
Yep.
And then if you're in this digital screen here and you push OK accidentally,
yep,
be mindful it changes to miles per hour.
Okay.
If you feel like you're going too fast, you generally are.
So, main battery, that's the main one.
Dave's just bringing in the patrol for the last drive.
Oh well, it's the last drive.
Yep, half her up. Swap out of one and into the other.
From this to that. Oh, I feel a bit sad. You feel a bit sad?
Yeah, it's been a good car. So.
Okay, now you can say it.
You don't have to wear your windcheater anymore. You can wear a ram one, all right?
Oh, beautiful.
Upgraded ugly
upgraded
vest.
Guess what? There's one for you too.
Thanks, James.
No worries, and that's your tow bar tongue there.
Yep, all right.
I'll just chuck it in the back of the car.
Righto, first drive. And it's done 195 k's already. Well, they did have to drive all the way to Forestfield today to get it. He said he hunted high and low, and they're the only ones that could do it for us.
Cheers for that, James.
Thanks,
good
James.
Job. Oh, look at that number plate. Woohoo! Oh, she's a big one.
she is.
Let's call her Rosie. Whole lot of Rosie.
No, we're not calling no car, no names. Oh, look, you're locked in.
Lock it in, Eddie.
Oh, how's it going, Dale?
Yeah, pretty good. We've done nearly 100 Ks.
Yep.
When we picked it up, obviously they've been racing around in it, so it had 17.5 litres to the 100. And after driving 100 kilometres, or nearly 100, we got it down to 15.3.
Pretty good.
Yeah.
All right, now we've
got to
do our first fuel fill-up.
Yeah, so we did ask for a tank of juice there, you know.
Oh, no, but look, I got this little...
Oh, yeah, so we got a few. We've got an umbrella.
We got an umbrella.
That'd be good in Tassie.
We got some little jackets.
And
we got
singing.
I'm alive, I'm happy. And we got some stubby holders, some water bottles. And
what else?
And a smile because we're happy. Are you happy?
Yeah, it's different to drive. Like, I don't feel any different driving this on the road than I did the patrol. I think the only time we're really going to notice anything different is maybe when we're trying to park it. But, you know.
Oh, what did you say about that today?
That's a bonus.
Rude.
She's been dragging me around the shops looking at bloody pillows, you know, as if we haven't got 15 of the bloody things already. Now she wants 15 more.
Yeah.
And so now I can just drop her there and she can go shop by herself.
Oh, tuck and roll.
Oh, look at the sky.
Oh, it's pretty.
Why are you whispering?
We've got to be whispering all day.
Well, whispering in one shot while we're in the
weirdos
in the office while he nicked out to go and get something.
Putting the right fuel in, though.
Yeah, diesel.
It's diesel now.
Yes, got to get used to that. We've had diesel all our lives. Then we went to petrol V8 and the patrol. Now we're going to go back diesel.
Ooh. See how much it's going to cost us. How much a litre is it? It's not cheap Tuesday.
No, it's pretty cheap here. $1.73.3 and we get 4 cents on, so $1.69.
Okay. Is it empty?
It's in the red. Okay. We had 90 Ks left in the tank, so we'll soon see.
Alright. So you put in 100 litres.
100 litres. Doesn't even have a fuel cap on it, it's one of those pushing ones.
Show me, yeah.
You just push the nozzle in, add blue.
We'll have to find out where we can get some of that stuff from.
Go pay now. $173.30.
Oh, and discount off that.
Don't scratch it on the bush. I'm like, don't scratch it on the bush.
Don't need to worry about scratching. The tub's going to the wreckers.
Oh, yeah. All right. So, first car park. It's pretty much empty,
Lucky
but that's
it's
okay.
Empty, yeah.
And chocolate run.
Come on, hurry up. You're getting chocolate. I need a beer. Yeah, maybe.
Oh, we're just discussing whether we need some...
That's high beam. That's low beam.
We're just discussing whether we need a light bar or...
Yeah.
Spotties. I'm thinking, yep.
Yeah, we're going to need a set of spotties or a light bar or something for it.
Okay, it's taken us 2.5 hours to get home through the traffic. Dave's just, cheers. Cracked a beer.
Even got the Ram stubby holder. And look at this. Look at this.
Have a look at it.
No sleeves.
Have a go at
There's even one for Nick. She'll be wearing it because she'll be bitching it's cold.
Mm. So speaking of cold, Dave's just done a quick measurement on the ram and we'll have to measure it in the morning for sure. We may have to cancel Tassie. I think we're going to be too long.
We're only allowed 15 metres, so...
Well, no, it's not that you're not allowed to have that. When I did put in
we
the extra...
We are only allowed.
Yeah, it's, they're obviously fully booked, so... Hmm.
Might have to postpone it, but we'll see. We'll have to back it up to here and get a measurement and
in the daylight.
Daylight and see, but she's pretty close to the 15 metres.
But woohoo, she's here.
Yeah, so I mean, we took the long way home. It was about 130 odd k's, but it was peak hour traffic, so we had to miss the freeway. The Tonkin Highway was still bumper to bumper.
Yeah.
Then we had to get fuel. Oh, and then Nick ran out of chocolate, so we had to get some chocolate.
Of course.
So we're going to end this one here. We've got the car. Next week, we'll have a bit of a rundown after we had a bit of a play with it, give us a good look at it. And then after
well, that... Well, we haven't even done that really,
nah,
so, yeah.
We're trying to fiddle with stuff as we're driving along. Nick's going off a nut.
Oh, sorry. I'm short, sorry.
Yeah, well, it's got a longer handle. Hold it. Lower okay. Love.
Oh, you hold it then.
If you hold it down here, you don't have to put your hand up. That's better.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah.
Anyway.
So.
Leave this one here, like and subscribe, and we'll catch you next week.
No worries. I'm going to edit this right now. So, well, what's the time? 6:45.
Shh. Go.
Let's go.
Bye.